We're talking about tween domestic abuse. We're here with Dr. Elizabeth Richeson, clinical psychologist, and Stephanie Nova, chief executive from Day One, and also a lawyer.
Well, typically it's progressive because otherwise people aren't going to engage in a very difficult relationship from the onset. And so it's a wonderful relationship, and sometimes I think too wonderful, you know, because the facade is so incredibly important to the perpetrator. And so as the relationship progresses, then that's when the problem began to show up, but very subtle ways initially, ones that aren't going to make someone go running away.
Girls of this age are just sort of starting to get a sense of self. So talk a little bit about that.
They're very vulnerable, and until someone has a real strong sense of whether we call it self-esteem or self-confidence, I think the vulnerability is greater, and so that makes it more likely that they can be pulled into these relationships. And plus, there's a real sense from these guys that, you know, they undermined any developing self-esteem, and so that just makes them continually more and more vulnerable. Sometimes even saying things like, you know, no one else will have you, there's something wrong with you, picking up anything that they might use against them to make them feel less than.
Exactly. And they also, you talked about how a lot of these girls feel isolated. Talk about that sort of isolation.
It's a lot to do with the controlling mannerisms that are used. Typically, it starts maybe with even a sense of jealousy. And they often want to say, you know, I don't want you to spend so much time with your friends. I want you to spend more time with me. And so that isolates. And when you begin to isolate someone, the controlling aspect of that, then, of course, they don't have anyone to sort of run these ideas by. Is this really part of a good relationship? Look at what this guy's doing. They have no one to bounce that off of.
Right, because a lot of times you were telling me, like, they don't even necessarily recognize the signs of an abusive relationship, right?
Absolutely. In fact, on our website, jenniferann.org, we've got the 10 warning signs of an abusive relationship. But, you know, the top three have a lot to do with the controlling that we've already talked about. Blaming, in other words, the perpetrator isn't blaming themselves, of course, or taking responsibility. But they're saying, you know, you made me do this, or your action to look at that other guy made me jealous, and so on. So there's a lot of blaming. And then finally, there's threatening. A lot of threats. And sometimes the threats are even about what they might do to themselves. If you leave me, I'm going to kill myself. Time that someone's leaving, that's the time that the relationship is in most danger, or the young person's in most danger, because the other person, the perpetrator, may feel, if I can't have you, no one can have you. And part of the control is to stop you from leaving, so I can, you know, escalate my abuse, or in the worst case scenario, kill you. For free, please go to the website and request those cards. On the front of the card is the 10 warning signs, and by the way, you can even see that on the website, so you don't have to get a card if you don't want it. On the back, there are the ways out, and some of the things that are suggested, which I think are such key points, is that you have a plan. That's number one. Have a plan. Know what you need to do. Don't get yourself in a situation and then not be able to respond out of fear or anxiety or just being frozen in the situation. So have a plan. Another one that's so important is to have a code word, so that your friends or your family are going to know that you're in trouble. If they get a call or you call them and then you're using this magic word, they'll know to send for help, because sometimes that other person is right there in your face and you cannot do something safely. So the code word. I also ask people to always make sure that they have some money in their pocket. You know, money can get you a phone call. It can get you a cab ride, whatever they need to get away from or to get help. You know, sometimes cell phones are taken away from you. So know what those phone numbers are that you want to call. There's a lot of good ideas there, but mostly have someone that you can talk to. If you don't feel you can talk to a parent, then please find a professional to talk to. It could be someone in your church. It could be someone at your school. But find someone. Make sure someone knows. And if you're not sure if the relationship is abusive, ask.
Right. Ask. What is your website?
It's www.jenniferann.org.
Great. Thank you both very much for being here.
Thank you.